हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू फिजिकल साइंस डिजिटल क्लासेस महबूबाबाद। माई सेल्फ नरेंद्र बाबू कोटला, पीजीटी केमिस्ट्री टीएसएमएस महबूबाबाद। टुडे रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट एट कर्व्ड सरफेसेस, क्लास 10 पार्ट 3। टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्पेरिकल मिरर्स। सो रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट बाय द स्पेरिकल मिरर्स। And coming to here, what is spherical mirror? A spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface is the part of a hollow sphere of glass. Spherical mirror is that mirror whose reflecting surface. So the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror is the part of a hollow sphere of the glass. So then that is a spherical mirror. So some of the spherical mirrors, example. So these are the spherical mirrors. And coming to the next, the spherical mirrors are of two types generally. One is concave mirror, converging mirror. Just now we discussed converge and diverge. Concave mirror, so it is also called as converging mirror. And the second one is convex mirror, which is also called as diverging mirror. Spherical mirrors are two types. They are concave mirror or converging mirror. Number two, convex mirror or diverging mirror. So now we will discuss briefly this about concave and convex mirror. In that, the first one is concave mirror. What is concave mirror? So it means the spherical mirror in which the reflection of light takes place at the concave surface is called concave mirror. That means whose reflecting surface is bent inside. Simply, so it has a reflecting surface that bulges inward. Concave mirror has a reflecting surface that bulges inward. Called concave mirror means it is having the reflecting surface that bulges inward, inside if it bulges. So let us see the example here. This is the concave mirror. So if you see this, in this, so the inside, the reflecting surface. So this is having the reflecting surface. Okay, so this is concave, which is bulges inward. So it is bulges inward, that is concave. Okay, so and hard surface is outside and reflecting surface, it contains the, so inward, then it is called concave mirror. And second one is convex mirror. Convex mirror. So in this, so the spherical mirror in which the reflection of light takes place at the convex surface is called convex mirror. So the spherical mirror in which the reflection of light takes place at the convex surface is called convex mirror. So reflection that takes place on the convex surface. Actually, convex mirror is a reflecting surface that bulges outward. Actually, convex surface, if you touch that mirror, then it bulges outward. If you close your eyes, if you touch the convex mirror with your fingers, so then you can feel that, so the surface of the mirror which bulges outwards, that means the reflecting surface, if it bulges outwards, then we can consider it as a convex mirror. And we can observe here, this is the convex mirror. If you, when you are touching with your fingers, this is the reflecting surface. Now this reflecting surface is bulges outward, then it is called as convex mirror. If the reflecting surface is, so bulges inward, then it is called concave mirror. Now here in this case, the reflecting surface is bulges outward, then it is called convex mirror. So now we will discuss some basic terminology here. So in that, so let us see here, this is the, so a hollow sphere. Imagine this is the hollow sphere. Hollow sphere. Just now we discussed concave mirror or the convex mirror, that means spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors are the part of the, or the reflecting surface of the spherical mirrors are the part of a hollow sphere, glass sphere, hollow glass sphere. So now consider this is the hollow glass sphere. So in this, so from here to here, if you cut this, if you cut the piece, so this is the concave surface. We can, why? Because so we are just making the reflecting surface inward, bulges inward. That's why we can consider it as concave mirror. This is concave mirror. Now take this black part here, and if you cut this part up to here, And if the reflective surface, so if you make the reflective surface bulges outward, then we can consider it as convex mirror. So we can make this not only the concave mirror, we can also make it as a convex mirror. When it becomes a convex mirror, so then outside part of this mirror, if you paint it with the silver coating, or if you make it as a reflecting surface outside, bulges outside, then we can consider it as a convex. Otherwise, if you make it inside of this reflective surface, if it is having the reflective surface bulges inward, then it is called as concave mirror. Okay, so now we will discuss some terminology. Center of curvature. So what is the center of curvature? If you take this hollow sphere, glass sphere, in this the center point, so it is the center of the hollow sphere of the glass of which the mirror is a part. So actually this is the mirror, mirror is a part of this hollow sphere. In this, to this hollow sphere, the center part is generally called as center of curvature. So it is the center of curvature. So for this concave mirror and convex mirror, so the center of curvature is like this. Okay, so now, so the center of curvature generally that represents with the letter C. Center of curvature, this can be represents with the C. It is not part a mirror. Actually, if you take the mirror, so mirrors always we used to view the mirror from the side part. If you observe a mirror, so directly from front, then we can see like mirror is looks like a halo. That means it looks like a spherical in shape. But so while drawing in this light unit, so generally simply we can consider, we can able to draw the mirrors in side view like this. We can able to draw this side view only. Okay, so actually the center of curvature is not a part of this mirror. Center of curvature is not a part of the mirror, means actually this is the only part of the mirror. So in this, so the center of curvature is not part. Where center of curvature will present, in the sense like this, at this point the center of curvature will present. For this, so convex mirror, where the center of curvature will present, in the sense like this, so the center of curvature will present. This is an imaginary only. Okay, so it lies outside the surface of the mirror. This is not a part of the mirror. Center of curvature will lies outside the part of the mirror. The C of a concave mirror is in front of it. If you see, this is the concave mirror. So actually this is the reflecting surface. Otherwise you can take here, this is the reflecting surface. So the C will be present in front of this reflecting surface. If you consider this is the reflecting surface, the center of curvature is present in front of this. Okay, and coming to the convex mirror, in this convex mirror, reflecting surface is outside. Okay, so the C of a convex mirror is behind this. Actually, the reflecting surface is this side. But behind to this, the center of curvature will be present to the convex mirror. That means the C of a concave, what is C? C in the sense center of curvature. The center of curvature of a concave mirror is in front of it, but the center of curvature of a convex mirror is behind it. This is the major one. So now we will discuss one more point, that is radius of curvature. Radius of curvature, actually the center of curvature and radius of curvature seems like same only. Okay, so radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is the radius of the hollow sphere of glass of which the mirror is a part. It is represented by R. The radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is the radius of the hollow sphere of a glass of which the mirror is a part. So that means, so actually if you take, this is the hollow sphere of the glass, the radius of this, okay, the radius of the hollow sphere of the glass, if you take, this is the hollow sphere of the glass, the radius of this glass is generally called as radius of curvature. So it can be represented by the capital R. If you observe this, the center of curvature C and the radius of curvature R, both are having the same. C is equal to same, we can consider like this. Okay, right. So now we will take the two mirrors to explain some more important terms. We will take two types of the mirrors. One is a concave mirror, another one is the convex mirror. Okay, so now we will define what is pole. Pole in the sense, the center of a spherical mirror is called its pole. The center of a spherical mirror is called its pole. So it represented with P. Pole generally represented with P. It lies on the surface of the mirror. The center of a spherical mirror is called its pole. Let us see here, this is the concave mirror. For this concave mirror, what is pole? So if you observe this, this is the center of the spherical mirror. If you consider, this is the spherical mirror. So the center of this spherical mirror is called as pole. And for the convex mirror, here it is the center of the, so it's convex mirror. Then we can consider it as the pole P. We can represent it with the P, pole. Okay, it is represented with the P. It lies on the surface of the mirror. And coming to the next one, so now imagine this, for this concave mirror, this is the C. What is this? Center of curvature. This is the center of curvature. What is this? This is the P. If an imaginary line, a line which draws or which passes through the center of curvature to the pole, if any one of the line which passes from the center of curvature to the pole, then it is called as, so, principal axis. Now, have you got this? So, an imaginary line, see here, which passes through the C to P. Now, see, it is moving. So, an imaginary line is passing through the C to P. Then it is called as principal axis. Okay, what is the principal axis? The straight line passing through the center of curvature and pole of a spherical mirror. The straight line passing through the center of curvature and pole of a spherical mirror is called its principal axis. Okay, so now we will go through the, so, convex mirror. To this convex mirror, so imagine this is the center of curvature. This is the center of curvature C. Now, an imaginary line which passes through this, or the straight line which passes through the center of curvature and the pole, so, of a spherical mirror, is called principal axis of this convex mirror. Watch this. Now, an imaginary line is passing through this. Okay. An imaginary line is passing through this. Again, I will show this. So, an imaginary line is passing through this. Then we can consider it as principal axis. So, the straight line passing through the center of curvature and pole of a spherical mirror is called its principal axis. Okay. Aperture. It is also important. What is aperture? The portion of a mirror from which the reflection of light actually takes place is called the aperture. That means the portion of the mirror from which the reflection of light actually takes place is called the aperture. For example, if you take the concave mirror, so this is the reflecting surface. Now observe my cursor. If you observe the cursor, so I am moving from one end to the another end of a concave mirror. This is the reflecting surface. So that means this total part, that means that this total part is called as aperture for the concave mirror. Now we will go through the convex mirror. If you see this convex mirror, so I am just moving my cursor. This is the reflecting surface of this convex mirror. That means the reflection takes place here, the reflection takes place here, the reflection takes place here, reflection is also takes place here. That means, so the portion of a mirror from which the reflection of light actually takes place is called the aperture. For the convex mirror, from here to here, this total part is aperture. For convex mirror, from here to here, the total part is aperture. Okay, right. So next important one is principal focus. Very, very important this is. So, what is the principal focus? Actually, principal focus is two types for the, one is for concave mirror and one is for the convex mirror. So, try to understand this principal focus for concave and convex mirror carefully. So, let us see the concave mirror. In concave mirror, so what is the principal focus? So, rays of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection meet at a point on the principal axis is called principal focus. That means some of the rays of light, so they are moving here, and after the incident, hence they meet at a point. That means they will converge. Why? Because we can also consider it as a converging mirror. Okay, rays of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection meet at a point on the principal axis is called principal focus. Let us see the rays. Now observe the rays carefully. So now incident light rays are moving like this. So after the incident, these light rays, so they will undergo reflection, and after the reflection they meet at a point. At this point they are meeting, okay, and this point is generally called as principal focus. Understood? Again I will show this. Okay, so observe this again. So now, so the light rays are incidenting here. After reflection, these light rays converge and meet at a point. See here, these light rays, they are converging and meet at a point, and at this point they are meeting, and that's why this point is generally called as F. We can represent it with F, principal focus. One, actually converging takes place. Okay, that's why this mirror is generally called as converging mirror. Rays of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection, they meet at a point on the principal axis, are called principal focus. Now, have you got the principal focus of a concave mirror? What is the principal focus of the concave mirror? Right, then we will go through the convex mirror. What happens in convex mirror? Rays of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection get diverged and appear to the principal axis. Diverging in the sense move out, so they are not closing, that means they are not coming closer, they are moving out, they are moving away. The rays of light parallel to the principal axis after reflection get diverged and appear to the principal axis behind the mirror, called the principal focus. Now if you observe this, the light rays are incidenting on the convex mirror. So at this point, and when incident, actually, so the incident light rays are diverging here. See, they are moving away, so they are diverging here. Okay, and these diverged light rays, so just seems to be converging here. Okay, so reflect and get diverged and appear to the principal axis. They are just simply moving towards the principal axis. Actually, this is the imagination. After the extension of, we should not consider, this is not the, so converging. Actually, you have to see the reflected light rays are diverging here. They are moving away. But these reflected light rays seems like, reflected light rays, they are seems like they are coming from the principal axis. Why? Because, so if you observe this, they are coming from like this only. Okay, so that's why we can consider this as the principal focus of the convex mirror, that is F. Okay, so this is the principal focus of convex mirror. So now we will go through the, so one more important one. So that is focal length. It is also very, very important. So what is focal length? So it is the distance between the pole and the principal focus F. It is the distance between the pole and the principal focus F. Okay, so that means it is the F and it is the pole. So between these two is generally called as focal length. In a spherical mirror, the radius of curvature is twice of the focal length. What it is, we will see here. Okay, so now what is the focal length? In the sense, this is the focal F point. Okay, so now the distance between the F to the P, the distance between the, so this F to the P is generally called as focal length of this concave mirror. So we'll go through this convex mirror also. If you see this convex mirror, so the distance between the F and P, if you observe the distance between the F and P, so here this is the focal length. That means it is the distance between the pole and the principal focus is called as, so, focal length. In a spherical mirror, the radius of curvature is twice the focal length. For example, so from P to F, the distance is focal length. So then, if you observe this, the radius of curvature or the center of curvature. So our radius of curvature and center of curvature, both of the distances are same. Okay, if you observe this, the radius of curvature is twice the distance of this, so focal length. That means R is equal to 2F. Then where F is equal to R by 2, we can represent like this. This is about the focal length, very, very important to us. Okay. Right, so concave mirror has a real focus. If you observe this concave mirror, in front of the reflecting surface or in front of the mirror, so this focus or F, it is present. okay, and it is in front of the mirror. Convex mirror has a virtual focus. Actually, this is so an imaginary part only. This is virtual focus, and it is situated behind the mirror. For the convex mirror, the F is situated behind the mirror. Okay, right. So coming to the object. Object is the thing that forms an image on the screen. Object means, for example, if you take the book, if you take the pencil, if you take a ball, okay, so anything that forms an image on the screen, that forms an image on the screen, that is called object. What is image? Image is the reflection of the object on the screen. Okay, image is the reflection of the object on the screen, that is called the image. So images are generally two types. One is virtual image and another one is the real image. So in that, the first one is virtual image. Virtual image in the sense, the image that cannot be obtained on a screen. Okay, the image that cannot be obtained on a screen, that is called as virtual image. So a source where image is formed, that is, that means example, image in mirror. If you stand in front of a plain mirror, we can able to see our face. So that is the virtual image. That image we cannot obtain on a screen. That is the virtual image. We cannot get it on the screen. If you bring anyone up the screen, we cannot get it on the screen. That is virtual image. We cannot obtain on the screen. Second one is real image. The image that is formed directly on the screen. So the image which is formed directly on the screen, that is called real image. For example, so image on theater screens. An image on the theater screens. If you observe the theaters, an image directly that falls on the screen, that is real image. Now, have you got the difference between the virtual image and the real image? What is the example of real image? Image in the mirror. We cannot get it on the screen. Real image, we can get it on the screen. So that is real image. Okay. So these are some basic terminology. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.